for this tutorial, we're really going to be creating painted some clouds, and I'm just going to show you guys a very basic, easy way to do clouds, how complex you want your clouds to go from this point on. It depends on what you're painting, what kind of tools you have, and how complex you really want to be. I'm going to show you guys the easy way that I like to teach my classes, because it is quick, it's easy, and most of the time you get very decent clouds. Basically, what I'm doing here is I'm just gonna get my flat brush with white paint, and I like to start my cloud with just a straight line down below on paper, just like that. Okay, and then I'm gonna make all the shape of the clouds with circle motion. So I'm just gonna get my brush in here, and I'm just gonna do some circle motions as I go. The edges of my cloud, I'm gonna extend this one a little bit. The edges of my clouds are going to get thin, the middle of the clouds are going to be big, and circle motions are going to be long, and then I'll just going to end my cloud with more skinny edges on both ends of the cloud. Okay? So that's how I'm going to do my first layer. I'll just stretch this cloud, and I'll just do round motions. And one thing that I would watch for is make sure you're not making any points with clouds. You want it to be nice and fluffy. And you know, of course, depends on what you're trying to paint. Okay, so that's the first thing that I do. The next thing is I'm going to decide where I want the highlights to be and where I want the shadows to be in the sky. So once you decide that, I'm going to have my highlights to be on the left of my cloud. So everywhere here will have a shape. I'm going to look for the right side. And using yellow, I'm just going to go here and still use the circle motion. I'm going to create a little highlight in the yellow on the right side. Now, it doesn't matter very much how much I'm putting, because remember, I'm going to do another shading of white over this cloud. So I have my white, I add my yellow. You have to decide on what side is going to be your highlight, what side is going to be your shadow. In this case, my highlight is on the right side of every little shape I have in the cloud. So with that done, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go and get more white, and I'm going to repeat the process, but I'm not going to cover all that yellow on the cloud. I'm going to leave some of that yellow stone. Okay? So, I still go in the circular motions on my painting, and I'm leaving some of that yellow stone. And depends on how much your painting is being translucent or not, you're going to have to decide how much shade, how many layers of white you might have to do. And now, with the blue, it's a little tricky, because usually students in the beginning, they tend to use a lot of blue. In reality, you just want your brush to be a little dirty with the blue. So what I do usually is this. I got my blue on the brush, and then on my side of the plate, I kind of like just white. So I get just a little dirty blue on the brush. And then I'm gonna go on the left side of each of my shapes, and I'll add a little depth to my cloud. Now, the shape of this cloud is going to be whatever you want it to be, because it's your design, it's your idea. Once I'm done with the blue shadow, I'm going to do one more layer of white, just to bring some of those white highlights of the clouds back, because you know, clouds usually are mostly white in the sky, or gray, depending on the day that you're cloud watching. You guys been cloud watching before? Mm-hmm. Just sit in the background on the backyard, look at the cloud. Look, it's a monkey. So I'm gonna do another cloud right here. It's gonna paint all the way to stretch out. And this one is not gonna be as much volume as the first. It's gonna be a little more flat. But the process is still the same. You start that's my highlight. And once I do this, I'm gonna get my glow and my shadows.